2004, I established the Syrian Center for Media and Freedom of Expression. And in 2011, I also funded the a program for documentation, violentation in Syria. So I start work in this field since 2011. And because of the report and work regarding the mass violence and war crime happened in Syria, the authority arrested me. As perhaps 100,000 of Syrian in this period torture and the bad condition and the leak of medical support, he faces all of these situation.
عمليات الإبادة، جرائم الحرب، جرائم التعذيب تحاول أن تلبس لبوس قانوني، ولا أظن أن هذا يخفى على أحد، سواء من جهة السلطات السورية أو من جهة المحاكم الشرعية أيضاً.
To spend almost 4 years in the prison in this condition, it's not easy. I'm very happy and thankful that I'm still alive. A lot of my friend and colleague, they are not lucky like me. But this makes me in some kind of responsibility. Feel now this is my duty, this is my responsibility for the other people who are still suffering this kind of condition or torture, for the whole children and civilian which I met, I left them in the prison. So I feel it's now not only in general, like I worked before 2011 about the ethics and value. Now I feel that there is a humanity, there is a people, they need my work, they need my effort. And because I learned from many other country experience that you can't talk about democracy or development without freedom of expression. It's not acceptable to leave millions of civilians suffering daily and just we talking in general about their suffering without do anything. All of us, even who don't care about Syria but they want to solve the refugee issue, who want to defeat ISIS of this kind of thought, we should work more, we should stop this war. Without peace, without justice in Syria, nothing will solve and the whole world will become more dangerous and not safety place. اليوم كلياتنا لازم نوقف وندافع عن حقوق الإنسان.